Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. I apologize for being late to doing some of these videos for the past couple days, and now we're going to be taking a look at the Scimitar F1, or Scimitar. The debate on whether or not it is pronounced Scimitar or Scimitar started all the way back in the early days of RuneScape. You were there, I was there, we remember those days. I, however, will be referring to it by Scimitar, which I believe is the proper way to pronounce it, but I could be wrong on that. Anyways, continuing on, the Scimitar is a late 1950s subsonic twin-engine naval fighter jet strike fighter developed by the renowned British submarine aircraft manufacturer. Soon, pilots in War Thunder will have the chance to take control of the Scimitar F1, joining the ranks of the British aviation tree in the upcoming major update. Briefly, it is an early British Cold War naval jet strike fighter, possessing a high degree of versatility thanks to its combination of good flight characteristics and suspended ordnance options. It's a Scimitar F1, it's a jet fighter for Great Britain of the 6th rank. Good flight characteristics and wide selection of secondary weapons for its pros and cons are that it is subsonic and has no afterburner. There is some history right here on the unit. And then we have some pictures, some screenshots, as they say. Right here, it's not a bad looking plane, I'll give it that, you know. I think it looks kind of neat. In War Thunder, the Supermarine Scimitar F1 will be a new jet fighter awaiting pilots at rank 6 of the British aviation tree in the upcoming update major. Wait a minute. That's a typo. We'll be referring to it as Update Major from now on. Although, historically speaking, the Supermarine Scimitar F1 has a less than stellar service record owed mainly due to the high maintenance requirements and numerous accidents. These problems are something that War Thunder pilots won't be affected by in-game, and they'll have the chance to fully take advantage of the Scimitar's excellent flight characteristics and combat versatility. Before we dive into all the things carried by the Scimitar that can go boom and make others go boom as well, it's certainly worth talking about the Scimitar F1 itself first. Namely, the heart and soul of the Scimitar F1 is represented by two Rolls-Royce Avon 202 turbojet engines, generating an impressive 11,150 IBF or 5,057 kgf. Each, the Avon engines and on the Scimitar allow the aircraft to reach a top speed of 630 to 640 knots or 1,170 kilometers an hour, Mach 0.95, at sea level, which with a climb rate of 95 to 105 meters a second. Besides being subsonic, the Scimitar also doesn't possess an afterburner, meaning that unlike some of the more recent additions to the game, the Scimitar F1 will feel, from a performance point of view at least, much more like a classic top jet fighter of the day, and will therefore become a must-have in the collection of old-school jet jockeys in the game. There's another nice screenshot of the aircraft. However, offering seasoned War Thunder pilots a taste of nostalgia doesn't mean that the Scimitar F1 doesn't bring with it the taste of the modern either. This modernity can most clearly be noticed within the Scimitar's weapons arsenal. Besides its primary armament of four 30mm Aiden cannons, the Scimitar can also carry bullpup air-to-ground missiles as well as early Sidewinder air-to-air missiles, thus substantially bolstering its combat capabilities. Apart from all these high-tech weapons, pilots who prefer a more analog approach to warfare will naturally also have bombs and unguided rockets available to them. Interesting, this awesome Scimitar model is brought to you by your fellow player. Nov A29R, or NOV A29R, by the War Thunder Revenue Share Initiative. Read more about the revenue share here. Yeah, so I was actually told about this a little while ago, but the Scimitar is actually created by one of the users that plays this game, which is really fucking epic. I love to see that kind of stuff, see actual players' models get implemented into the game properly. I don't know too much about how the revenue share program works. I know, like, if you make a premium aircraft that gets added to the game, you basically get royalties. Each time somebody buys that, you actually get a percentage of it or something like that. But I think if you make a tech tree item like this, you get one big payout. I mean, it's a beautiful looking model of the aircraft, so I'd say give them all the money you can. Overall, the Supermarine Scimitar F1 gives British pilots a highly capable jet fighter, effective in both air battles when used as a pure-blooded fighter, as well as in combined battles, where pilots can take advantage of the Scimitar's vast ordnance options to turn it into a deadly close air support aircraft. And here we have a few more screenshots. There's the, man, that looks so weird from that angle. Nice side shot, nice butt shot, and that's a nice angle. The Supermarine Scimitar F1 is on final approach and is expected to arrive at the top ranks of the British aviation tree with the release of the upcoming major update. In the meantime, stay tuned to the news to find out what other shit is coming. So yeah, lots of other stuff to talk about, but British pilots get a new jet aircraft to go with. And if you haven't been paying attention to the news, here's some other stuff that's coming at the next major update. They have announced, of course, that Italy is getting their naval forces finally, which brings with it a rank 2 premium P-420, as well as their rank 3 premium destroyer. They're also getting the Trento heavy cruiser and the MS-15 motor torpedo boat. Great Britain is also getting 3 new types of unguided rocket weapons for their aircraft. The United States is getting the F-3H2 Demon jet fighter, naval fighter, I believe. And France is getting the Mirage 3C. For ground forces, we've got things like the new low-tier Char D2 for the French ground forces. The Chinese are getting a new low-tier AA vehicle, the ZSD-63. The United States are getting a new high-tier experimental light tank, the HSTVL. And the Chinese are getting their rank 6 premium bundle pack, finally, in the form of the Type 69-2G, as well as the map Italy getting a complete rework, supposedly. And also getting a rename. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.